Have you ever wondered how your blood type is determined by your parents? Well, it starts with understanding the basics of blood types. There are four main types: A, B, AB, and O. Each of these is determined by the presence or absence of specific antigens, known as A and B on your red blood cells. So, when you say you're type A, it means you have A antigens, and the same goes for type B. So, that's the basics of blood types. But how do we inherit these from our parents? Each person inherits one blood type allele from each parent. But what does that mean exactly? Well, when we're talking about blood types, we're referring to the genetic traits passed from parents to their offspring. These traits come in the form of alleles, which are different versions of the same gene. In this case, our focus is on blood type alleles, specifically A, B, and O. Now, here's where it gets interesting. The A and B alleles are dominant. That means if you inherit an A or B allele from one parent and an O allele from the other, you'll end up with either type A or B blood. The O allele, on the other hand, is recessive. So if you inherit an O allele from both parents, you'll have type O blood. So we each get one blood type allele from our mother and one from our father. But what combinations can these alleles make? Now let's look at the possible combinations of blood type alleles. Imagine two parents, both with type A blood. They can pass on either an A or an O allele to their child. Similarly, if both parents have type B blood, they can pass on either a B or an O allele. Now, what if one parent has type A blood and the other has type B? In this case, they can pass on either an A, B, or O allele. Things get a bit more interesting if one parent has type A blood and the other has type O, or one parent has type B and the other has type O. They can pass on either an A or an O allele, or a B or an O allele, respectively. And finally, if both parents have type O blood, they can only pass on an O allele to their child. These are the possible combinations of blood type alleles. Now, what does this mean for the child's blood type? So, how do these combinations determine the child's blood type? Let's break it down. If a child inherits two A alleles, or one A and one O allele from their parents, they will have type A blood. On the other hand, if the child inherits two B alleles, or one B and one O allele, they will have type B blood. When a child inherits one A and one B allele, they will have type AB blood. And finally, if a child inherits two O alleles, they will have type O blood. Remember, the A and B alleles are dominant, and the O allele is recessive. This means that if a child inherits an A allele from one parent and an O allele from the other, the A allele will be dominant, resulting in type A blood. And that's how a child's blood type is determined. But there's one more factor we haven't discussed yet: the Rh factor. The Rh factor plays a crucial role in determining blood types. So, how exactly is it passed down? It's actually inherited separately from the ABO blood group. If both parents are Rh positive, Rh plus, there's a 93.75% chance the child will also be Rh positive, and a 6.25% chance the child will be Rh negative, Rh. On the other hand, if one parent is Rh positive and the other is Rh negative, there's a 75% chance the child will be Rh positive and a 25% chance the child will be Rh negative. Intriguingly, if both parents are Rh negative Rh, the child will also Rh negative. So that's how a child's Rh factor and blood type are influenced by their parents' genetics. That's it for today's video on blood type inheritance. We hope you now have a deeper understanding of how your blood type is determined. If you've enjoyed this video and learned something new, please consider subscribing to our channel, Medicine Health 360, where we aim to expand your medical and health knowledge. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up to support us in creating more high-quality content. We also encourage you to share your thoughts, questions, and any feedback you might have in the comments section below. We love hearing from our viewers and engaging in educational discussions. Thank you for watching. Remember, better health leads to a better life.